It's a Pumbaa Bumbaway.
Oh, Pumbaa Bumbaway.
Pumbaa Bumbaway.
Hey guys, welcome to CJ's first cooking show. If this is your first time, you just
get ready to
get
live.
Get ready for a freaking wild ride. Am I white? Wascoey Wabbits.
I'm hunting Wabbits.
Before we get started, do me a solid. If you like us, subscribe, click the icon, the bell, all that good business. That way we can get down to business.
Business.
Because I'm wearing business socks. That's why they call them business socks,
business
baby.
Man,
I know,
and I'm down to just my socks. It's time for business. That's why they call business socks.
Guys, today I'm going to show you a fun way to utilize... When's the last time you had a pita pocket?
It's been a hot minute. A hot pocket.
Hot pocket. Today I'm going to show you guys how to make a bacon chicken ranch... Or bacon chicken Caesar pita pocket.
Say that five times, real
quick. Bacon chicken Caesar pita pocket chicken. Yeah, I can't do it.
Let's do it.
Let's get started. There's basically two elements that you have to do here that's gonna take the most time. Bacon.
Yeah.
And chicken.
Uh-huh.
So let's grab them both, well, one at a time. Let's head over here. We've got our pro series in line today, Nate.
Oh, I see you're doing the safety dance.
Well, I did have it cranked up and it was smoking hot, so we're now back to the safety dance. Let's go ahead and put down our Wright's bacon. Uh-huh. Essentially what you're looking to do with bacon is not burn it.
Yeah.
That's the most important step.
Everyone
and I have taken so much heat on my bacon and online. I'm gonna do my best today not to burn the bacon.
Your best.
Your best.
Okay.
Next thing, chicken. We're about to be through the most difficult part of this.
Okay.
And it's not that difficult. Hold on, I got my oil is getting hijacked.
Jeez.
To the bacon over here.
So you don't want to do bacon first and then cook the chicken in the bacon fat?
Well, we could, but honestly, it's just not that big of a deal.
Oh.
Not for this recipe.
Got it.
Yeah.
Got it. I'm so, picking up what you're putting down.
Are you?
Well.
So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching CJ's first cooking show. We're done today. We're going to ring the bell.
Wait, so no seasoning on the chicken?
Not right now.
Did you just phantom ring?
I did a mock ring.
Oh.
We're going to let this cook for a second. I'm going to focus on this while everybody takes a moment.
Mock.
Yeah. Bird. Thank goodness for the bell because I've cleared the palate, prepared myself.
You're refreshed.
For the salad ingredients. This really is a simple one, guys. Let's talk about our interior of our pitas.
Our interior?
The pita interior, like we have an interior decorator. I guess I would technically be the pita interior decorator.
The pita hired you to decorate his foyer.
That's exactly right.
I know what a foyer is. Foyer.
Dang it, I can't find the quote in my head, but I was thinking True Lies. He's like, that's a nice piece.
It's a nice piece.
We've got our new Blackstone schwing. We got our knife here. So we've got some baby cherry tomatoes.
Did you say schwing?
No, but that's also appropriate.
Schwing.
So we got some baby cherry tomatoes here. I'm just gonna give these
a little cute baby.
A little slice, just to essentially, we want to make a little bit of room.
Do you always cut them north to south like that?
Yeah.
I like going east to west. Do one.
Really?
It gives you a pinwheel look.
This?
Yeah.
It's harder to get in the pita though. And I am a pita interior decorator. Yeah, I think, is this north to south? I mean, that definitely is officially north to south.
Yeah.
Now, you could go north to south, and we could do east to west, and that would actually make it...
A little smaller.
Feel pretty good about that.
Hot pocket!
Oh, yeah, I'm slow cooking my bacon, y'all. This is due to post-traumatic syndrome. and the fact that everybody gives me grief online. Whoa.
That was a good flip you got there.
Hey, why don't you shut your yap?
What's a yap?
What's a yap?
Let's have a look at our chicken.
Oh,
yeah.
So no seasoning on the chicken yet.
No seasoning on the chicken.
Okay.
We're going to do a lot of mid-seasoning.
No pre, just
not,
mid and post.
Just mid and post seasoning. It's like editing.
Oh.
You think that's enough tomatoes? Yeah, I'm gonna do a few more of these real quick because we do have a nice presentation that's gonna be used with our taco rack that will be a pita rack, which will...
Is it low-lying fruit? Never get too many Wayne's World quotes in there.
Is there such thing as too many Wayne's World quotes?
No.
I don't think so. I don't think so at all.
Hi, Wayne.
Hi.
Hi.
We've got our romaine lettuce. Guys, pro move on your pita interior decorating. Go ahead and get rid of the top. It doesn't have a lot of crunch.
Yep.
Because we're doing this really for the crunch and that yummy taste of what's romaine even taste like?
Romaine.
Romaine, exactly.
It's got the same crunch as iceberg, but it's got a little bit more flavor.
I suppose you're right.
Iceberg really tastes like nothing.
Which is why it tastes like everything.
Maybe
they couldn't figure out what to make chicken taste like, which is why chicken tastes like everything.
So guys, we're gonna finish chopping up our romaine lettuce.
That's a good move right there.
We're gonna get this, really we need to get this to a size that is gonna fold well, that's gonna sit well inside of our pita, and just rotating the chop and getting it.
You need a bigger bowl.
You're gonna need a bigger boat.
Well, I think that's a sufficient amount.
Well, we're kosh. We're kosh so far.
Actually, that is quite a bit. All right, I'm gonna check my bacon.
Yeah, you should.
I really should.
Although I haven't seen you burn bacon in like a long time.
Well, it has been a while, but you know,
it's like
still.
A week.
Shut up, jerk. All right, our chicken's looking good. You know what we probably, and I got a comment about this. I've seen a few of them. Not enough bell rings.
Oh, well get after it.
We didn't have enough time. Dang it, that's another one. It's just so good and so easy to use. All right, we'll be back in a sec. Now this next ingredient, this shout out goes to my girl Betty and my other jam, Nay. I could do pre-shredded Parmesan.
I almost bought you pre-shredded.
But Nay, I say.
Nay.
See what I did there?
Nay.
Nay, I say, we are going to actually shred our fresh Parmesan.
My baby boy's all grown up.
You know what? Sometimes when a recipe is this simple, yeah, you gotta figure out ways to have enough time on video to actually get through a recipe without it being like 3 minutes long.
I feel like you're creeping slowly into my territory here.
Which is wrapping up quick or at elevated?
You're shredding your own cheese. You're making your own salad.
Whoa.
You're cutting beautiful little tomatoes.
Whoa!
You called them beautiful baby tomatoes?
Those tomatoes suck and they're ugly. This is probably not a normal Caesar thing.
Definitely not traditional.
But in my pocket, I wanted to have a little bit of a vinegar.
Yep, a little punch.
Punch to it. So I'm gonna just gonna.
No.
I'm just kidding.
Don't hurt yourself now. Can't do it.
I'm gonna pull out some of these delicious mild banana peppers. We're just gonna throw them in. No need to cut them up. Whoa.
Some of that liquid in there is not a bad idea.
Oh no, I love it. So our bacon is looking almost done. So almost done that I'm going to prepare for said bacon to be pulled off. That way I'm not left in the lurch. Wishing I had that.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think about my chicken? It probably needs another minute.
For a second. You could cut it. I mean, what are you doing with the neck?
I'm about to cut it. See how we're doing in here. Oh.
Hello.
We're looking quite nice.
You're almost there.
I'd say we're just about there.
This is the nice thing about doing cutlets instead of chicken breast, especially if you know you're gonna cut it. You can go fast and furious and get them done real quick.
Definitely.
Yeah.
But the thing with bacon is, I've learned, pull it off just before you think it's actually done.
Uh-huh.
I do like the taste and feel a little of that, some of that fat. But speaking of that.
Crunch. Ooh, pull the chicken.
You knew where I was going. I'm gonna toss this around in that bacon fat. That's gonna give us some fun flavor. Plus, it just seemed like the right thing to do. I think I have one more thing to do before we're actually ready to start building.
What are we doing?
I'm gonna slice up my pita pockets. Pocket. You guys remember the old commercials, like the original commercials back in the day? They're like Hot Pockets and Lean Pockets too.
Hot Pockets. Try Lean Pockets too.
So guys, here's what we're gonna do with this. We're gonna grab our pitas and we're gonna cut them in half, exposing the
pocket.
Awesome
pocket.
So you wanna be gentle.
Okay.
Open up, expose.
Here we go.
You got your little fellow there and he goes, Rudy Tootie.
I have the rooty tooty.
I'm gonna do one more, and by the time I finish cutting up this pita pocket, it's gonna be time to pull off our bacon and our chicken. So our bacon is for sure. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Remarkable.
Gorgeous.
Pulling that off over here. Yeah, and our chicken is officially done too.
All right.
I'm gonna take some of these over here to the cutting board, and let's get to cutting.
I like your style.
Thank you. Okay, so basically what we're gonna do here is, this is up to you. You can chop it into slices like that, which you get a bigger bite, or we can take them into kind of a smaller realm where we get a little bit more bite size. Ethan, how are you feeling? Which one do you think?
Bite size.
All right, bite says it is. So we're gonna go through our chicken and cut this up, cut them into those slices, and then just start chopping and getting them ready for our salad mixture. And there we go, we've got bite-sized pieces just the way Ethan likes them. Right, Ethan?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now I'm gonna do just a pinch of salt.
All right.
We're doing this before before we go into the bowl.
Almost like you're making a board sauce. Dude, what's happening? We've been hanging out too long?
I need to drink more. I need more water.
No.
Oh, that's bad. And salt and pepper, and the last thing we're gonna do is add a bit of our remarkable Parmesan Ranch Blackstone seasoning. Gonna give this a little mid-dusting. Don't worry, we're not done with the dust. And then into the bowl we go. That's the best way.
Oh man, look, it's like, that looks delicious, man.
I know. What can I say?
Ethan, great idea.
Great idea, Ethan. One more bit into the bowl before we add our sauces. Now,
is the cheese?
The cheese. It's fresh grated. It's fresh grated. So it's gonna be extra special with love.
That's what Betty says.
I don't know, that's what I'm gonna say.
Yeah.
Now, our sauce. It's a Caesar.
Yeah.
We need to add some Caesar.
We've gotta add some Caesar.
Now, of course, be as generous, be as generous as you like. You do want this to be very full of flavor, but we're not done there. We're also going to be adding some of our Blackstone Italian Serve and Sear.
All right.
We're cross-pollinating flavors. It's the best of both worlds.
It's the best of both worlds.
Okay, here we go.
I like the little wave you do with your hands.
Thank you. Now, this is gonna be a lot more loose than our Caesar, but not to fret.
It'd be a nice coating on all those ingredients.
Exactly. Guys, we're getting close to being done here. We're just gonna toss our Caesar salad, and dude, I mean, is it really this simple? Now,
were you about to say, restaurant quality food doesn't have to be difficult?
I wasn't about to say that.
I was thinking it.
Well, I know you were thinking that. I know that I thought you thought that I was.
Oh, I don't think I'm a lot dumber than you thought that I think that I thought I was once.
Do is slice up our bacon.
Are you gonna throw that in a mix, or are you gonna use that as kind of a little crinkle garnish?
I was gonna just do a garnish.
Yeah, let's do that.
Cause we got a lot of flavors going on inside of our pita interior, and pita interior 101 says don't overfill. Also, wise men say forgiveness is divine, but never pay full price for late pizza.
Wise men say forgiveness is divine, but never pay full price for late pizza.
Yeah, it's Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. You got me on that one already.
I know. And I got him on another good one the other day.
What?
What's a guy gotta do to get some food around here? It took you a while, and you might have forgot still.
Wait, isn't it Fievel?
No! So stupid, I love it.
Fievel goes west.
We're ringing it and bringing it, bro.
Pre-plating parched.
It's the traditional pre-fight donut.
Traditional pre-fight donut.
Yeah. Okay, we're back. It's time to plate. So this is pretty simple, folks. It's not gonna be complicated. Simply grab your pita pocket, get your interior ingredients, and you get her, you set her down.
All right.
And we're gonna do this to fill up our entire rack. What am I gonna do with a gun rack?
I don't even own a gun.
Let alone many guns.
That would necessitate an entire rack.
What am I gonna do
with a gun rack?
If you're not careful, Wayne, you're gonna lose me.
I lost you 2 months ago.
We broke up.
Get the net.
Ethan, cheese or bacon first?
Bacon
it is.
Oh, we're doing more cheese?
Yeah.
Wow.
So we're gonna do.
Wow. Dude, gorgeous.
I know, right? Our last garnish here. Got some fresh.
Beautiful.
Parmesan. And boys, That is, wait, 98% done.
What, there's more?
A post-dusting.
Okay.
All right, here we go. So we got to play the wind on this one, our Parmesan
Jeez,
ranch.
It is windy.
And we got some serious wind. Whoa.
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 Whoa. Gosh, Ethan, it's all over Ethan's camera.
One more thing. Seriously.
My goodness.
Because I love to dip. This Italian
You're
sear
gonna dip
and serve.
Your pita? I've never seen someone dip a pita.
What?
Is that a thing?
Yeah, of course it's a. Of course it is. I got like Parmesan cheese in my eye. We did a mid dust. We did a post dust. We've garnished.
It's a pita party.
Hot pocket. Dude, let's go taste it.
Let's dip.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
It's pita pocket time. Oh, okay. Here we go. Let me get this out of here. Yeah, I want some juice. Oh no.
You're gonna dump it. Yeah, that's a better
move. This is a better move. There we go. No, it's all right. It's okay.
It's okay. It's okay. Come on back.
You're gonna love this, bro.
It's good? Dude, everything was so simple, so easy. I feel like I could taste it without even tasting it.
Yeah, you can. You should taste it while tasting it, though.
That's probably a better idea.
Ethan? Mm-hmm. You've never had one.
Nope.
Get in here.
All right. I'm gonna make one for Ethan.
Get over here.
Verdict.
Did you hear a giggle?
I like it.
You just like it? You don't like salad.
Yeah, I haven't had that much salad.
Coming back to you. Don't you worry. But it's time. It's time! Prestigious comments of the week.
That was so anticlimactic.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for CJ's favorite comments of the week.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to CJ's favorite comments of the week. This is the segment in the show where we read your comments, we screenshot them, I read them, and we all have a good time.
Oh, you write them, we read them.
And sometimes we laugh at my expense, sometimes we just get excited that you're a part of the community. So, here we go. Starting from the top in no particular order. This comes from my home slice, Tyler Payne. He'd been gone for a while. He's back. My wife told me that if I watched the new episode of CJ's First Cooking Show, that I'd be sleeping on the couch. My phone was dying and my charger cable wouldn't reach the couch. So I played the new episode on my TV. Tyler, you rebel, you. Ring that bell! And to Tyler's wife,
CJ's
sorry.
First Cooking Show, bringing marriages together across the country.
And number two, this comes from Nay.
Hey, Nay.
Don't act like CJ is your best friend when he can't even speak a word on your show, when he shares his whole show with you.
That's from my show?
I share my show, I share my pockets, my pets' heads are falling off!
Our pets' heads are falling off!
Nay, to you, my darling, I ring that bell.
Don't agree with that.
Oh, we're ringing
that
bell. I sing to you.
You know why CJ doesn't talk on my show? Because he has nothing to say.
Whatever. Okay, this next comment comes from Mike Hobson. I kind of have to sing it. I gotta kind of have to sing it. I can feel it coming in the air tonight. Patty melt, chili cheese fritos, and a few bell rings. Oh Lord.
He wrote it? That's a great comment.
So Mike, to you, we ring that bell in your honor. This next comment comes from Beard Bra. All these movie, music, and pop culture throwback references are amazing. New to the channel, because I'm finally going to be getting a Blackstone.
All right.
The show is great. Please tell me the other episodes are just as great.
Probably not.
Nah, dude. Nah. This is the golden one right here.
Yeah, you landed on the best one.
Ring the bell for my man who's new to the channel.
Beer,
here we go. Beer, brah. This next comment comes from someone very special. This is from Rob, and I'm not sure if I'm saying your last name right. Wicca, I think I am. Or Wicca. Hey, looks better than the wasabi. CJ, another great show. It was so awesome meeting you and your family at Wasabi. It made our weekend. Keep up the great work. And if you ever need anything or help in the good old PC, let me know. Thanks.
Wait,
guys.
A wasabi?
For the first time, somebody recognized me in public.
So I'm out in front of Wasabi. We're in Plant City. And for the first time ever in my life, ran into somebody who recognized me from Blackstone. It's like one of the few people apparently that watches my show.
So to Rob and your family, I say thank you for, actually it was your son that recognized me. So cheers, here's to Rob. This next comment comes from Matt Rage. Anyone else concerned that as CJ's level of cooking goes up, that so will his level of seriousness on his show?
What?
I mean, one hoity-toity show is enough, right?
Whoa.
No hate. Love both you guys. I wonder whose hoity-toity show he's referring to.
Todd.
Yep, that's it.
Yeah.
Cheers to you, buddy. This last comment comes from Robert. It says, hey, buddy, how's your day going? Robert.
That's it?
My day is going well. How is yours? Okay, that's it. That wraps up CJ's favorite comments of the week. Thank you guys so much for hanging out. As always, please leave comments down below. If you write them, we definitely read them. And sometimes they'll make it on to CJ's favorite comments of the week. But in the meantime, do yourself a huge favor and make chicken bacon ranch or chicken bacon Caesar pita pockets. You will love them. If you don't love them, it's because you're Ethan.
I love them.
Yeah, he does. But be sure to like and subscribe. Make sure you check out Nate's Cook, Eat, Repeat, Betty's Family Style, Todd's Tobin Zone, a.k.a.
Let's Give It a Try.
All of those fun things. Go to blackstoneproducts.com to check out this recipe and everyone else's. But in the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, if you did not know this, this is CJ's first cooking show.
That's right.
And we cook.
And we quote.
Right on! Ring that bell. We are done. We will see you guys in the next video. But first...
Now
I've had the time
of my
life. I have failed this way before.
Ethan, he's doing it again.
Crystal.
I went for the bass.
The time of my life. Are you ready to catch me?
What?
And I owe it all to you.
No.
Together.